he's yawning.
Is it in yet?
Is it in yet? Oh, bollocking balls.
If you like bollocks and you like balls, you like bollocky balls.
The game for all the family, but not Uncle Jimmy, because he's a bit suspect.
That'll do, pig. That'll do.
Ah, that's all right. Move your lard over, then.
The hoi hoi.
Oi oi.
East straw.
East parka.
Together we are.
Bala.
Yeah, we are.
What's this?
Well, today is mostly our monthly mumble.
Monthly mumble three.
The third. It's a little late because of salute. Salute happened. That was a big blurry kind of thing.
So. No, I don't think we're late. I still think we're early, actually.
Oh, yeah. All right. Early for next month.
There's too still much exhausted late night from staying up having sex with each other.
That's what it is. I had a roleplay session. It's like after Gloomhaven, you can't get to sleep.
Yeah.
You know, because it's like you're all rumorating.
Yeah. So yes, we're still playing Gloomhaven every Friday night and still enjoying it.
Yeah, and we'll still put the videos up.
Even if you don't want them.
They seem to get a few views, seems that people are watching them.
It does get some views and some nice comments from people, which is always lovely.
Mikey.
Thank
you, Mikey.
Thank you for your lovely comments.
If no one else is watching them, we know you are. Thanks for that.
And you're having a beer at the same time, so
which
that's
is
nice.
Good, in the honour of the Battle Hammer.
So,
I'll just go into the questions. I haven't had a proper look. So, these are questions from last month's Mumble, and then we'll just chat a bit after that. So, a question from Graphic Novel Kid 92. What's your guy's favourite Guild Ball player, and what guild would you like to see in the future?
Well, guild in the future, I would like to see... I'd still like to see the Messengers Guild done.
Yeah, Messengers Guild would be nice. I can imagine lots of... Especially now we've had the new Hunter's stuff. Was it Scatha?
Oh, fuck no!
She can, like, create a snowball and start passing it around. So it kind of fits... The Messengers Guild would have a similar kind of thing. They can
make a rumour.
Pass things around. That would be cool. I know there's rumours of the Blacksmith's Guild floating around because they're mentioned in the fluff.
I think I'd also like to see a Sluts Guild.
Well, of course.
Just because the models would be great. Kick it in the gash.
I'd like to see an Entertainer's Guild, like a travelling circus type thing.
A lot of people have done those, haven't they?
Yeah. There's a good union one floating around. And I think Harry's the strong man, Ranger's the ringmaster and stuff like that. I think that'd be cool. Because I had an idea for the mascot would be a seal bouncing the ball on his nose. So he'd have close control and like a reasonable pass skill because he can pop it around. But he'd only have like move three because he's a seal. You know, I thought that'd be cool. And you could have like a pair of acrobats who would have linked in the same way that Honor and Army do. So they'd go together. You'd have a strong man who's your big guy. You know, your ringmaster would be your captain.
It's obvious.
You'd obviously have a fucking psychopathic clown. You just have fucking knives and murder shit, because why not? So I think that'd fit well. I can also see why they wouldn't do it, because it's kind of a bit cliche, isn't it?
Yeah. Favourite player, though?
I'm going to make... I wouldn't say it's a controversial choice, but it's... Favourite player is not a team that I play at the moment. I think my favourite player, fluff and stats... is Grayscales. I fucking love Grayscales. I think he's great. The fluff is great. He's this old boy. You kind of know he's been there. He's seen there. He's done it. He's been around. He's like, oh, yeah, I've been there. But as a player, I really, really like... I'd love to have Grayscales on any of my teams because he's just...
Well, solid. You can't because he's a fisherman.
Well, no, I'm just saying. You know, I just love him. I think he's great.
My favourite player. Oh, that's difficult because I've got so many... favourites. But who's my ultimate favourite? Ooh, depends on the mood I'm in.
Yeah.
Oh, damn it, that's a real difficult one for me.
Like Fluff? Is there anyone that you, the Fluff, you really like of? I mean, Straw's not read the season three. I haven't read the full season three stuff. I've read clips.
Fluff, or as I still like Obulus, because he's a...
Evil plans.
And apparently the season three stuff for the Morticians is really good background as well. Cool. I don't know, because I haven't read it yet. It would have to be someone in my morts, I presume, but... I still think Cossit's going to be one of my favourites, just because I just so like the model.
Yeah, and the season, her season three, it's like they made her not necessarily better, but they made her better at what she should have done anyway, if you see what I mean. I think she's a really good player in that she does a thing, you know what she's there for.
She's there to kill.
She's there to kill stuff.
And then fall over.
Yeah, and then fall over, yeah.
So, yeah. I think that's about the best answer you're going to get out of us on that one. The other one was from Nick Ty.
Yes.
Asking why you bottled out.
I'm scrolling down.
It was right at the bottom.
As for Gateway Games, how do you find the converting process? Does it get very... This is from Spyro.geek. Does it get very messy? If I'm honest, I don't really convert anyone. You know... I'm not really exposed to that whole kind of converting people to game from not playing games into playing games. Most of my friends are gamers anyway, so I don't
And
have
if
to
they can't be bothered
that.
To be playing the games in the first place, then they can just fuck off.
The one thing I would say about Gateway Games, I think more so than non-Gateway Games, is the theme is really important.
Yeah.
Because if you can get someone on a theme... The game stuff, they kind of just roll along with. But if they know...
And understand the theme.
Yeah, because then they've got an idea of what they should be doing.
You know, if they're a superhero fan, you know, they're like watching all the Marvel films and that, then you get them into something like, you know, the superhero games.
Yeah.
And start bringing them in that way.
And
you know, that way they'll... Oh, no, that's a superhero. Yeah.
And you know what they should do. You know, Cyclops has got eye beams, so you know that he's got eye beams or whatever it is. Like, you know, when you run Zombicide... for like Rob and his folks. They're not gamers, but they know what zombies are and they know how zombies work. You run away from the zombies or try and kill them. That's your kind of your job.
Yeah.
So I think it's more important. Whereas we might play something that people might not... that might be a bit abstract or might not have a theme that you really are into because you think, oh, the game's good. But they don't have that kind of idea.
Yeah.
So that's kind of the only thing about converting people. Like, if someone likes Star Wars, I play X-Wing, blah, blah, blah.
Or Armada, because it's better.
Well, yeah, why... Jinx Panduit, a.k.a. Nick Ty. Parker, why did you bottle out of getting the 1,000 Battlehammer tattoo?
Because he's a pussy!
Because I'm saving myself for the...
2,000!
100,000.
He's saving himself for the 2,000! When he gets it on his cock.
It's not that I don't want a Battlehammer tattoo. I've just not got any tattoos. And now I've got to an age where I'm like, I don't really want one now.
But you're having the Battlehammer one on your head.
Yeah, apparently.
Right across your forehead.
We'll see.
He's a pussy. That's the answer.
Wes Ady asks us, so with Salute around the corner, do you guys have any must-see trader stands, apart from Steamforged, of course? Well, we just got back on Sunday. So
Wes Ady was the first person we saw.
He was actually the first person we bumped into.
And yes, we did have a beer. Thank you very much.
Yes, thank you. That was very kind.
It was very good. Very decent of you.
You can go back
that
and watch the Steam. Watch the video about... things.
Salute.
Although a little, let's go roll down. A lot of them are replies to questions rather than actual new questions. But if you want to know stuff, if you're interested in our thoughts about games or anything particular, let us know in the comments down below, and we can start a discussion about like, what do you think about such and such?
Yes, that'd be good.
Yeah, because we always are interested to hear your.
Because we like waffling, but you might as well give us something to waffle about.
Yeah. I guess a bit of Salute stuff that we didn't film. I chatted to Alessio Cavatore for about 10 minutes, completely forgetting that I had a camera in my hand.
in his hand.
Because we were at the... Right, so we were at the Warlord stand looking at stuff about the...
Conflict 47.
Because the new stuff which you'll have seen on the salute thing looks really nice. Love the little automated carrier with a little... looks so cool. And the new Japanese stuff looks great.
Beep, bleep,
the Wonderbot, yeah. And then I was like, I want to ask a question about something. I can't even remember what the fucking question was now. Turned round. Oh, this guy, he's got a Warlord shirt on. Oh, hello, you're Alessio Cavatore. You're like the king of games, you know. You're not here for Labyrinth, and we had a big old discussion about that.
We got some photos at the end of it, and then I turned around to Park and said, you do realise you had your camera in your hand all the time?
Like, right fucking in my hand. But I just got chatting. Really nice bloke.
Fuck. Everyone's nice blokes.
Yeah, yeah.
Apart from the women. They weren't nice blokes. They were nice women.
Yeah.
But yeah. I mean, obviously we've got 7 TV to play very soon.
Yes.
Maybe.
Might have gone a bit balls deep on that. But I'm glad. It looks fun. And the miniatures are great.
Have you been reading the rules?
I have been reading the rules.
Good lad. Obviously the big point of conversation at the moment is the new Warhammer 40k rumours.
Yeah.
Which are setting the internet alight, aren't they?
Indeed they are.
Have they got it right this time? We don't know. We'll have to wait until we get a game, won't we?
It does seem that...
Did you see the stat difference?
No, I haven't seen that yet.
Yeah, there's a movement stat, which is you move, just like old times. Ballistic skill is a number you roll over.
Oh, so
weapon skill is a number you roll over. Strength and toughness are basically the same. Wounds, there are more wounds depending on, you know, whether you're a grunt or a hero. Save rolls. But yeah, things like dreadnoughts now will have lots of wounds. And when vehicles and big monstrous creatures get damaged, because they'll have the same stat line, they get weaker.
Oh, that's cool.
So that's a nice idea. So you'll have your tank. You know, your tank will have the same stats as a bloke, but it might have like 30 hits or something. So you start wearing it down, and then its performance is affected.
Oh, that's
which I like.
Yeah, yeah, that
I
makes
like.
More sense.
Templates are gone.
Oh. Oh, wow.
They're doing the same as they do in Age of Sigmar, where the weapon will do more...
More wounds to the unit.
Yeah.
And that's kind of good for competitive play, because, like... When Guild Ball, the 3-inch AoE is fine when you're hitting one or two models, but when it's like you're just kind of hovering it over and you go, well, I think I've got 10, well, I think you've got 5, you know, and it just stops arguments then, doesn't it?
Yeah.
That makes it quicker, potentially.
Initiative on charging, that should never have been
makes
charging.
Makes loads of sense for stuff.
Oh, well, I'm going to go charging in and I'm attacking last because I've got Power Fist. Oh, hold on, don't be talking daft.
Which will make combat more deadly. For people who you want to send into combat, they charge, they do damage. You know,
well, yeah,
rather than they charge, they all got killed.
Yeah. Although, funnily enough, psychers haven't been mentioned at all yet. But there is. I mean, you go onto the Games Workshop thing, and they're doing a daily kind of thing at the moment. But yeah,
from what I've seen of it, you know, and hearing you talk about it, it seems like they've gone from Age of Sigmar, learnt from it. And actually
changed it. Added it. Changed it.
Implicated. No. Implemented. Implemented things that are useful from it and not done things that maybe people didn't like so much.
Have you seen the galaxy map?
No.
Galaxy map, there's a fucking warp storm right across the middle.
Oh, right.
So, and then, they're not changing too much of the story at the start, but they're trying to build up on the Chaos Against the Imperium kind of storyline, I think.
Makes sense.
The initial release is going to be your main box, or rules, or whatever, and then there's going to be 5 major books released at the same time, which is basically all of your codexes in, so you'll have like...
tomes,
you'll have
whatever.
Yeah, that sort of thing. And then yearly, they're going to have an upgrade book. But it does sound like they've actually finally listened to the players.
And I know there was, as far as I recall, seeing things similar to Age of Sigmar, and you can kind of take anything, but if you take certain things together, they give you bonuses.
Yeah, you get combat, command structure, or command points, or something like that, I read. So yeah, all the Forge World stuff will be included. There'll be rules for everything. So everything you've got, all of your figures you can use. Which is nice.
The main rules are free online, I think they were saying.
I think that's right? What I heard as well, yeah. They're trying to get the rules out as quickly as they can to as many people as they can. I mean, and there's three styles of play as well.
Yeah, they've got the narrative play, the kind of your points-based stuff, and then the open general, just throw shit down and see what happens.
Yeah.
Could turn a lot of people back into the light of 40k.
A lot of people have been going, well, I don't really want to start 40k again, but if it's changed, it might be different.
And for people might be better. Like us who have already got a fat stack of 40k stuff that's just sitting about, it does mean that...
I am actually a little bit excited. Yeah, I don't like admitting it, but I am actually a little bit excited to see this. I want it to be good, because we've had a lot of good times playing 40k.
Oh yeah, and the fluff's been around for donkeys, and I like the whole idea and demons and fucking all that shit. I love it, you know.
I want it to be good.
Yeah.
Want it to we'll be see. Good. But I yeah, hope it don't is. Go, don't rush out and buy a codex now.
No.
But they will
Didn't they say they're reimbursing people they for are. Codexes if they buy them?
That's not Games Workshop, is it?
No, and I think that's, if nothing else, it just shows you. Whether it's good or not, you know, at least they seem to care and are involved with their community more. You know, it's a real paradigm shift for.
Yeah,
for
and they're saying there will be new races as well. Mm. So, are we going to see Return of the Squats?
Probably,
especially after these.
Everyone's been loving the Argonauts, haven't they?
Yeah, with the little flying boaty things. That'd be great for 40k, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it would. I do kind of like them. I would admit. I'm not sure about this, the one with like a steampunk moustache and a top hat, which I'm not sure about. But the rest of them are pretty cool. I like the more kind of the more basic ones, the normal troops, because all the rest are like Terminator armor, just pure gold. Whereas they've got the kind of basic troops have got like more like deep sea diver suits, you know, and they've got kind of cloth and stuff. I think it's a nice contrast.
Yeah, another thing on the 40k stuff is the moves will be different as well. So you know. An Eldar will be faster than a Space Marine moving.
Yeah, like
and a Hormagorn will be even quicker.
Yeah.
Which is what they used to do.
Because that was always the thing about the run, was like you can just roll shit on that run. And you're like, oh, well, great, I've got a fucking plus D6.
Yeah. They're saying you can get a 1,500 point game done, dusted in 90 minutes. Not the way he plays!
No.
You've seen how slow he is! Egads! See, now he's thinking of a witty response. We could be a while.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I mean, I'm interested to see what they do and how it goes.
It'll be time to dig out the old Space Wolves, White Scars, Demons, Imperial Guard, Eldar.
I also hope that they don't... The problem is, I appreciate that they're a business, right? They have to sell stuff to make money. And they're a big business, so they have to sell more stuff just to keep it going. You know, they've got more overheads because they're a large company. If they're giving away the rules for free, I don't want to see a lot of codex creep. Like, I don't mind if new stuff comes out, like new whatever, and then, oh, well, I can choose to buy that or not. But I don't want it to be like, aha, like when Knights came out. It's like, you can buy a Knight, but you will lose all of your games if you don't. I don't want that to happen.
I don't think it will frustrate me. But that's, you know, a Knight's going to have fucking shitloads of wounds as well, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
But they're saying everything will be able to hurt everything as well. Which is the one... Stats aren't capped at 10 anymore.
No.
So you can have someone with a las gun that might take out a tank. Okay.
Yeah.
Not too sure about how that might work. But it might be, you know, you need to roll a 6 to hit, now you need to roll another 6 to hit, that sort of thing. Then, you know, there's always a lucky shot, but you don't want it taken out of you.
And also, you don't want that to then become flip-sided in that if everything can potentially hit anything... Is it just going to be weight of dice? Like, if I've got three units of fucking 20 Imperial Guard with las guns, and they shoot at a Land Raider, and they blow it up because I'm just throwing that many dice at it, and eventually I'll get a 6 and then a 6 and then another 6, and then it's gone. I'm like, I'm not down with that.
But it was so bad. Did I hear right saying that if you roll a 6 and then if you roll a 4, any 4s as well adds to that sort of successes? Maybe I'd be imagining that from another game, but I think that might be something.
That might be 7TV.
That could be any bloody thing, couldn't it?
So many systems, so little brain.
So little brain. So, yeah, what we got coming up then? We've been playing Barrels and Badgers a lot at the moment. We are loving that because it's so cute.
And we're very happy to be in, happy and proud to be in the playtest group for that, so that's cool.
And we're still doing Slay Industries testing as well. And other
Drowned Earth, we've got to play again.
Drowned
as well.
Earth, we've been doing as well.
Big shout out to the guys at Third Law.
Guys, you still have all of our love.
Yeah, totally. The Kickstarter sadly didn't fund, and they decided to pull it because they figured that it wasn't going to fund. But they've learned a lot of stuff from it, and they're going to redo it. I think they said June.
June.
So if you are interested in Third Law, and you know, let us know because we can play it more. And then the Kickstarter will be back.
It will be back, and this time you will fund it.
Yeah.
Damn you, bitches.
I think, you know, they've. I'm glad that. I'm not glad that it didn't fund, but I'm glad that they've learned and come back.
Yes.
Because that's good. They haven't just gone, fuck it.
Balls to it. No.
You know, they see that not necessarily mistakes were made, but, you know, they can do it better. So that's good to know.
I think one of the big mistakes was the fact that they didn't have the figures done, did they?
People
want to see the figures. The art's lovely and everything, don't get us wrong, but you really did need to get the figures about. But it's a great little game, so I still do want to see it do well.
Big news from Salute. Wild West Exodus. Hopefully we'll have seen the chat about that I had with Stu about the new second edition. So that's coming. There'll be a beta test in May. So more games to play.
Yes. We will be doing this one this time around.
I like the idea of it, and it's cool, and it's like Deadlands, kind of, and I liked Deadlands a fucking lot. Deadlands was great.
I think it's kind of what Deadlands would have liked to have had in a miniature game. It's very that kind of feel, isn't it?
Yeah, Wild West.
So yeah, we did have a chat with the guys there, so
watch this space.
Watch this space for more.
I mean, you can go away and make tea and go to sleep and then watch this space again. I mean, you don't have to just sit there, like, watching this space for ever.
Just put on pause.
Yeah.
Until we tell you otherwise. But yes, expect us to be doing this.
Oh, what else?
Oh, God, there's so much other stuff we've got to be doing at the moment. It's crazy.
Crazy.
What? Something.
More games.
Something Dark Side. Oh, that's right, we've got Vengeance coming up, haven't we?
Yeah. Oh, Christ.
Was that 3 weeks?
Yeah, I think so.
So this will be the last one before Vengeance. Ooh, bloody
time
hell.
Time flies when you're having fun, eh?
So yeah, that's my birthday week and end as well. Eek, that's going to get messy.
Booze, booze, booze.
Booze, tits, tits, tits. And then, of course, there's something else happening in May. What else is happening in May? Vengeance. Chillcon.
Yeah, Chillcon. We go in our...
Oop North.
On our behalf.
Oop North. Oh, and of course the new Hailstorm album comes out.
Awesome.
Awesome.
As do Grace and Benediction.
Oh, yeah.
On the table. No. Give them a bash.
No.
Interested to see what comes out of Steamforged over the next few months, because I don't know anything. I'm not in.
He's teasing, isn't he?
But it seems to be rumours that when the Season 3 rulebook came out day before Salute, and then everything was kind of made public, and it was like, well, the other team isn't in there. And they're like, no.
Are they saving up for SteamCon?
I think they're going to release another team as a separate release that isn't in the book, because he did ask us, if you remember.
Yeah, he did, didn't he?
He did say, how do you feel about when we were fortunate enough to have Matt Hart come down and have a little chat with us. I don't recall if we filmed it or not. He didn't necessarily talk about it in any particular detail, but he did say, how do you feel about releases that aren't part of the main book?
Oh, that's right, yeah. Ooh,
we were like,
cheeky,
yeah, we're down with that,
bugger.
As long as it's cool, you know, as long as it's a thing, then
it feels
awesome. Right.
Yeah.
As long as it's not something that you think should be in the rule book.
Craft.
And I wonder how much of that, I mean, the Season 3 rule book is significantly larger. I don't know page numbers.
There's a lot of fluff
in there. So I wonder if they were like, let's focus on this as being a fluff book. Because if they try to make the book bigger with more things and more stats and more, then you've just got another bigger book, which is 40 quid instead of 30 quid.
So we're going to have Codex Guild Ball.
Yeah, kind of thing.
For each team. That one wouldn't mind that. You could get all the rules, you know, little rules pamphlet and put it into the team box. That'd be all right.
And also...
I'd like that.
One thing they've done recently, very recently in fact, is the Young Theron story arc.
Yeah, I've read none of it.
I haven't read it. I keep meaning to. But that gives you a lot of background on Century Wars and stuff and who he is. Because he's got like a tassel-y thing on his
belt. Yeah, someone said, what is it? It's part of the regiment standard. Yeah.
So that then opens it up to be able to say they can release a team with all the cards, like a box of plastics, for example, with all the cards in, and then release the fluff on the blog.
Yep.
So they've, you know, that they have done that before, similar things, so there's nothing stopping them doing that.
Yeah, because you don't need the rule book for special rules and everything, because they're all on the cards.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
so
cunning.
I wonder if that's a thing, maybe for SteamCon or... I mean,
is there a SteamCon this year?
Yeah. I assume it's in November again.
Oh, we better find out, haven't we?
Yeah, so I mean, that's... I'm not saying... I mean, I don't know anything, I'm just...
We know bugger all. No one tells us anything.
But I wonder if that's a thing they could potentially do.
It's a nice idea. Nice idea.
Yeah. See,
but yeah, so there you go. Monthly mumble. Mumbled.
What else? I'm sure there was something else I was going to talk about.
Well, I thought it was something else as well, but... brain is like toffee this morning.
Yeah.
There's nothing. I can't think of anything. Quickly looking around at games and shit and seeing if anything...
Still getting over fucking Salute.
I know, it's funny how... I don't know how those traders... I don't know your traders how you do it.
Mate.
I really don't.
It was a really good day.
Oh!
Oh, go on. Oh.
There is something else that happens in May.
Oh, what?
Hello!
I'm a wizard.
I'm a wizard against the orc undead.
Oh, yeah.
Cool mini. Another Kickstarter for Black Plague.
Green Tide.
Yeah. Yes. Against the orky undead.
Yeah, I'm interested to see what it is. What they do with it. I mean...
It's going to be orky undead.
Yeah, but you'd hope there's more to it than that.
Not really. I just want orky undead. And have you go, hello, I'm another wizard.
Yeah. No, I'm just interested to see what they... Because it's the first big box expansion, isn't it?
It is.
For Black Plague. What happened in the first big box expansion for Zombicide?
Do you expect me to remember?
Because then that was when they brought in the toxic ones?
Yeah, the toxics. No, was it toxics? It was toxic mauls. And then it was the... No, they were the last ones. It was Toxic Maul, and then it was the prison thing which had the berserker zombies in.
Mm-hmm. Oh no, the second, we've already had one big box expansion, Wolfsburg.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So I wonder what they're going to do with that.
I reckon there's going to be zombie orcs in it, and zombie orc fatties. And zombie orc parkers.
Hello. Extra fatties, yeah, probably.
So yeah, that should be quite fun.
Aye.
But yet again, we're not really seeing that till bloody next year. And we've got so many games coming between now and then anyway. You know, Twisted, Massive Darkness, Deep Madness.
Deep.
Bomb. Rising Sun.
Rise of Moloch.
There was another one, Chris has done. We're inundated with games.
Yeah.
Anyway. That's enough of us waffling on about shite.
Yeah. Let us know if there's anything you want us to talk about, if you've got any questions.
Subjects,
for us.
Questions. In the crotch box.
You want about our thoughts on whatever?
Well, not whatever, because if they say, well, what's your thought on, you know, trying to end war in the. I don't know and I don't care. Sorry.
I'll tell you one little subject before we depart.
I'm departing.
Like nostalgia versus good games, like all the, because they recently did Shadow War, didn't they?
Mm-hmm.
As a not Necromunda, but it is. So I wonder, like, sometimes when we've played these games in the past and we had such a good time playing whatever it was.
Would it be the same now?
And then you try and play it again, it's like, oh, actually,
it's a bit shit.
It was just the time, it was the experience you had playing it rather than the game itself. Like, I wonder how do you kind of balance that? Like, how much of 40K is the game at all? And how much of it is like, I've got my orcs that go wog, and that's, you know, that's the fun of it. It's not about the game, it's about the experience.
Interesting.
Again, talking about themes, you know, it's the theme of the game, but you go, oh, that's cool. If there's nothing that draws you in, you're never going to be engaged with it.
No.
I wonder how... Like, Dreadfleet, I was never fussed by it. I mean, I'm sure it's a great game. It might well be a brilliant game.
I don't care, but it's got a cloth sea in it, which we can use for pirates. Oh, totally. So that's what it was worth getting just for that.
Totally. And, like, looking at the stuff at Salute, you know, all the historicals with the little 6mm things, I'm just not even... I'm sure they're amazing games, but I've not had a particularly good experience playing them.
I had to giggle to some guy on Facebook or something, said, does anyone play so-and-so, because at Salute I had an impulse buy and he bought up an entire, like, feudal Japan army in, like, 10 mil.
Oh, wow.
He's like, I don't know why.
I just did. I do like the look of
hashtag
those.
I'm very good with money. Oh.
I did like the look. I like the look of a lot of the little 10 mil, 15 mil I was looking at, which was quite nice, because they're individually based.
Great for tank battles and stuff like that, yeah. I suppose. But for no, not the men that small. That's just way too much for my eyes to stream with. I can't be bothered. I mean, yeah, you can play on a battlefield this big. Nah.
But they don't. They play on fucking huge.
I know.
8x10 battlefields. Wait,
here's my fleet of ships over here.
Oh,
they're this big, and 12 foot over there is where you are.
Yeah, that was fucking hilarious.
And the cloud fighting game. I mean, what the hell was that all about?
Oh, yeah. I don't know if it was that one, but there was a dogfighting type game, and they were basically just, like, a plane with lots of planes around it. I'm like, that's not kind of how a dogfight works. But, you know, how do you recreate that on the table?
Yeah.
You can't, can you? Yeah. And I think that's why I am probably more drawn to that 28mm, 32mm scale, because that's a dude.
Yeah.
That's not 100 dudes. That's a dude. That grayscale was or whoever it is. You know, I know who that is and what they're doing. I can visualise it. Whereas when you've got, there's a block of men, there's 6mm, there's kind of 8 on there, just little blips, and they are actually 100 men or whatever.
Yeah, that doesn't work for me. Like, visually, it doesn't work for me.
No. But I can see the advantage of being able to do proper big armies, because that was always the weird thing about things like 40k and fantasy. When you do 28mm on a big scale, like, how many people are really... here? Well, apparently there's 30 men here. That's not really an army, is it? You know, how many men could they really get together? There was a couple of articles, just as a complete sideways tangent, on the Warlord website, a couple of blog articles, about ranges and casualties in your tabletop gaming. Because you think of, like, here's my block of 20 men, you killed 3, so they're dead. Realistically, they're not dead. They are scared away, or they've broken their weapon so they can't join in the fight, or, you know, they're just a bit nervous and they're there, but they're kind of not there. And the same with ranges. When you actually work out, like, yeah, I can shoot from here to there as long as it's a good day and I can see them and stuff. But really, they're hunking down in cover. You know, you're shooting in combat. It's, I mean, obviously, when we're talking about fantasy stuff like Space Marines, then that's different. But because if you're talking about World War II, so realistically, your range is that, because you're just throwing shots in that direction. You're not shooting at men. And I thought that was because you think, oh, they're dead. They're not dead. Mm. They've run away. He's broken his glasses or whatever the fuck it is. Now he can't fight. You know,
he's twisted his ankle.
And I think they worked out that, tanks, realistically, you might have damaged the track and it can't move, or maybe it's run out of ammo, or suffered a jam, or something like that, and that's what's happened. Because otherwise there'd be fucking millions of blown-up tanks everywhere, just littering the countryside. And it kind of makes you think, like, yeah, actually, that's how it is. It's not... Mm. And I think they said that 2/3 of all of your casualties, if you were to set up a battlefield and I wipe out, or I kill X amount of your men, 2/3 of them will just be back for the next, ready to go in the next fight.
Yeah.
But, you know, I kind of like that. That thinking about wargaming, because it is, you're trying to recreate something on the tabletop, whether it be real or not.
You just don't like hurting people, do you? Personally, I think everyone should be murdered horribly.
Murder! So yeah, go and check out the on the Warlord website, on the IR articles page. They'll be back a couple of weeks ago. Interesting. I think, you know, I find that sort of stuff interesting.
Oh, I'm glad you do.
Well, it's a mumble. We're supposed to be just chatting about shit, aren't we?
Are we?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, it's kind of brown and sloppy.
Oh. No, you need more fibre in your diet.
You don't mean that shit.
No, you need more fibre.
Oh, badge.
It's brown and sticky. A stick.
See what I got to put up with?
Yeah.
So there you go. That's about it, isn't it?
I think so.
I think we're done.
Yeah.
We're done.
Please leave shit in the, comments. Please leave stuff for us to talk about in the comments, because then we can talk about actual stuff rather than just blah.
Rather than just waffling and mumbling. But it is a mumble, so. Slam! Yeah, Rumble Slam. Go play Rumble Slam now.
Yeah, yeah. That was fun. That's got to go up, isn't it?
Yeah, I've got to put that one up as well.
That was fun.
I've got all these videos to put up. I better go get on with them, hadn't I?
Yeah.
Bugger.
Good segue. Like, better get on with those videos.
Yes. As in, bugger off, you lot. Go.
Don't forget to like and subscribe if you liked it and want to subscribe. If you don't like it, don't want to subscribe. You don't have to like and subscribe, but we would like it if you liked and subscribed. And until next time, stay hammered.
Beep, or else we can't eat next week.
Come on, moves. I've got those moves like Jabba. I've got those moves like Jabba. I've got those moves
like Jabba.